Despite an evacuation order, groups of people were found near Restiv Ta'al volcano. Dennis Stantonou joins us with that story. Dennis?
Yes, Carmina, Calabar Stone and Batangas disaster officials, along with Cebox and Philippine Coast Guard and other government agencies, went to Ta'al volcano island to check if the policy of no human settlement in the volcano island, which is a declared permanent danger zone, is being followed. As the authorities went to the volcano island in the area under the municipality of Talisay, they saw small houses and groups of men there. When authorities talked to the men, they explained that they were not living there permanently, but were only there to feed their fish in the fish cages. They also claimed that they are following the window hours, which only allowed them to stay on the volcano island from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. to feed their fish. However, authorities are doubtful because they saw many clothes in the houses, a vehicle machine, and various other animals. Because of this, the Office of the Civil Defense Calabar Zone Regional Director Rayan Direk Marquez said that the Coast Guard and local government units should have stricter monitoring to ensure that the regulations prohibiting settlement on the volcano island are being enforced. Marquez added that there should be a record of who goes to the volcano island and what time they arrive and leave, so that if there is a sudden eruption of Ta'al volcano, they will know who needs to be evacuated. OCD Calabar Zone will talk to the LGUs around Ta'al volcano island to ensure that no one is living on the volcano island. According to OCD Calabar Zone, they will closely monitor the fishermen who are heading to the volcano island to ensure that they also return to the mainland. Under Cebox Alert Level 1, economic activity is still allowed in Ta'al Lake as long as they follow the regulations set by the Protected Area Management Board of the Ta'al Volcano Protected Landscape. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Dennis Tato, there joining us on the line. Authorities in the Philippine province of Albay evacuate more residents amid fears of a possible eruption by Mayon volcano. Let's now get an update on the situation on the ground from our correspondent Jose Carretero. Jose.
Hi, Carmina. Evacuees in Albay due to Mayon volcano's unrest have now reached more than 4,000 families or 15,000 individuals. Albay Public Safety and Emergency Management Office Officer in Charge Eugene Escobar said they have evacuated all residents inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone of the volcano, which is more than 14,000 individuals. In Santo Domingo, Albay, there are residents inside the 7-kilometer extended danger zone who evacuated also due to fear for possible eruption. Santo Domingo Mayor Jun Agua said barangay officials from the 6 villages have asked the LGU to allow the residents to evacuate due to fear of possible increase in the activity of the volcano. Mayor Agua said the total number of their evacuees have reached 1,035 families or 3,720 individuals. But some evacuees, instead of staying in schools or covered court, have opted to make shanties. Residents say they chose to make shanties because it is more comfortable compared to the modular tents or classrooms. These shanties are made of bamboo and anahaw leaves. Some residents have put up their shanties under the trees for more shade. Mayor Agua said the LGU will provide electricity and water supplies to the evacuees in shanties. Half of the evacuees, according to Mayor Agua, are staying in shanties. Meanwhile, Alert Level 3 is still hoisted over Mayon volcano. State volcanologists have recorded 7 volcanic quakes and 309 rockfall events. 7 dome collapse pyroclastic density currents, which lasted for 4 minutes, were also recorded. The lava flow has advanced for a kilometer already, flowing in Bunga and Mitigalis. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Jose Carretero there joining us on the line. State volcanologists say Mayon volcano is showing a slight anomaly. Cebox says only 145 tons of sulfur dioxide were recorded Tuesday. That's far below the average of 500 tons per day. But the agency warns this does not necessarily mean the volcanic unrest make that the volcanic unrest is easing.
The sulfur dioxide is quite low, which could mean two possibilities. One is there is not really that much gas in the magma, which is the reason why we have a very quiet type of eruption occurring. The second scenario possibility is that the volcano is blocked right now and that pressure is building up. Unfortunately, the escalation can occur in a matter of hours based on the behavior being exhibited by the volcano.
The Philippine Social Welfare Department is giving out as much as 5,000 pesos per family affected by Mayon's unrest. This is on top of the 32 million pesos in relief goods given to evacuees. But the DSWD explains not everyone will be included in the priority list of beneficiaries of the cash aid program.
Ang pinaprioritize po natin dito, yung vulnerable sector. Kasi halimbawa po, yung mga displaced po natin na workers, halimbawa farm workers, hindi po makapag-kopras, hindi po makapagsaka, okay? So sila po, papasok po mas akma dun sa cash forward. And then kung talagang sabihin na natin, hindi rin po may hirapan din yung magtrabaho, like halimbawa, immunocompromised na, o mas vulnerable pa dahil yung mga indigent natin na senior citizen, ano po, yung mga pregnant and lactating women natin, so sila naman po yung mas pinaprioritize natin doon po sa ating tinatawag na cash assistance.
The Trade Department conducted surprise inspections in stores in Albay to check on their compliance to price freeze order. Irene Birol now joins us with that story. Irene?
Carmina, monitoring teams from the Department of Trade and Industry, Bicol, conducted on-the-spot inspections in various stores in Albay to monitor price freeze compliance. According to DTI Bicol Regional Director Dean Donabol, the price freeze was implemented in the whole province of Albay after a state of calamity was declared due to the continuing unrest of Mayon volcano. Nabol also pleaded for the business owners not to take advantage of the dire situation. The price freeze issued by DTI covers all groceries, sari-sari stores, water refilling stations, and bakeries. DTI Bicol also assured the public of sufficient supply of primary commodities like canned goods, evaporated milk, coffee, detergent powder, candles, bread, bottled water, and instant noodles. Consumers are encouraged to inform the authorities in case they witness vendors or business owners violate the said price freeze. Anyone who breached the policy will be charged a minimum penalty of 5,000 pesos up to 1 million pesos and imprisonment of 1 to 10 years. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Irene Perol. And let's now get an update on the weather here in the Philippines from Pagasa forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Chanel, over to you.
Good afternoon, everyone. So as of now, a southwest monsoon is affecting northern and central Luzon. So expect monsoon rains over Ilocos region, Batanes, and Babuyan Islands. Expect a cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorm over Cordillera, administrative region, Zambales, and Bataan. In Metro Manila and the rest of the country, expect a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and expect rains during the afternoon and the evening due to the localized thunderstorm. As of now, we're not observing any low pressure area inside and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. And that's all for Pag-asa Forecasting, Chanel Dominguez, and good afternoon.
Thanks a lot, Chanel.